Epithelial tissue are one of the basic types present in our complex human body. They are composed of polyhedral cells which aggregates and strongly adheres to one another. They have a special sheet of extracellular matrix called basement membrane always lie at the interface of epithelial and connective tissue. Based on their function, epithelia can be classified mainly into lining, which have the function of covering, protection and absorption, and glandular, which performs secretion. Of course, it can't be maintained as strict division because lining epithelial cells may also secrete, and at the same time glandular cells are distributed among lining epithelium. During fetal development, epithelial cells proliferate and penetrate underlying connective tissue, and on further differentiation develops into specialized organ called gland, and it is of two kinds. In first kind, the gland retains their connection with surface epithelium, where the connection forms tubular ducts lined with epithelium through which secreted material leaves the gland, and it is termed as exocrine gland. Inside the gland, the duct runs through the connective tissue septum and branches repeatedly until it gets smallest and end in the secretory portions of gland called acini. But in the case of endocrine type, the gland lose their connection with their original epithelium, and after that they are densely surrounded by thin-walled capillaries. Here hormones are secreted outside the cell where the blood vessels absorb it and distributes throughout the body by identifying the receptors on the target cells, and it is termed as long-range endocrine signaling. Secretory cells are arranged either as irregular cords like this or round follicle with lumen for temporary storage of secretory product. Thanks for watching. Hope you will like my video. Please share, subscribe and comment.